This film was photographed in Tokyo, Yokohama, and the Japanese countryside. The year is 1954. This is a military supply train en route from Kyoto to Tokyo. It is guarded jointly by American military personnel and Japanese security forces.
What's holding us up?
I don't know. I'll take a look.
Inspector Kita.
Sorry, Mr. Saran. No time for an interview now.
That train carried American ammunition, didn't it?
Yes, I have already notified Captain Hansen.
That's the story I'd like to follow through on, Inspector. How the American Army and the Japanese police work together when American Army personnel is involved. Mind if I tag along?
Perfectly all right.
The Japanese police were in charge of the investigation. But since an American soldier had been killed in the robbery, the Criminal Investigation Division of the United States Military Police was called in for cooperation.
Hello, Captain Hansen.
Hello, Mr. Saran.
The American sergeant is over here. The engineer and the fireman and the two other security guards were attacked. The chain marks are still on their necks.
Chain marks?
Yes.
Are they dead?
No, only the American sergeant.
Here. The stolen equipment consisted of five 50 caliber American machine guns and four boxes 50 caliber ammunition belts.
Five 30 caliber American machine guns and four boxes 30 caliber ammunition belts and
two boxes of smoke pots.
Smoke pots? Are you sure of that?
Yes.
I can understand them stealing small arms and ammunition, but what would they want with smoke pots?
I wonder.
We just had our first lead of a tie-up with the killing of that American sergeant 5 weeks ago in the train holdup near Fujiyoshida.
Let's have it.
An American civilian called Weber was wounded an hour ago, sticking up a factory payroll. Instead of picking him up, one of his own gang pumped three bullets in him and left him for dead.
Well, where's the tie-up with the train holdup?
Ballistics report says the three bullets in Weber came from the same gun that killed the American sergeant on the train, a P-38.
Is Weber still alive?
Just about.
If he talks, those three bullets might give us the answers we've been looking for. They turned on you like a pack of wolves when you were hit. Why cover for them? Come on, Weber, you're hurt worse than you think. Who fired the P-38, killed the payroll guard?
And the American sergeant. The same gun was used in both murders. Who is Eddie Spanier? Huh?
Eddie Spanier. You guys, you're a million miles off. He's got nothing to do with this. We're in a war together.
What war? Sticking up on our men and old ladies?
According to this letter, he wants to join you as soon as he gets out of prison.
Join you in what? What's the setup, Weber? Who are the others?
Maybe this woman can tell us.
Mariko. She doesn't know anything. She had nothing to do with this.
Then what are you afraid she'll tell us?
She's got nothing to do with this.
Then what are you afraid she'll tell us?
She's got nothing to do with this. It's nothing, you hear
me? Who is she? Who is she? Who is she?
My wife.
Your wife?
Yes.
That's not on the record.
2 months. 2 months. We've been married 2 months. Mariko. Nobody knows. We kept it on a QT. Nobody knows. Nobody knows. Only her uncle. Only your uncle and you.
Approximately 3 weeks later, a freighter from San Francisco docked at the port of Yokohama. Among others, it carried a passenger listed as Eddie Spanier. He headed directly for Tokyo. His first stop was at the Kokusai Theater.
Does it make? They said they'd show us the town, didn't they?
They don't speak English.
So what? We don't speak Japanese.
How do I get to the roof?
Right up that way. But I wouldn't go up there now if I were you.
Why not?
They're rehearsing. They don't like anybody up there now.
They got an elevator, or do I have to walk?
They've got an elevator.
Speak English? Anybody speak a little English?
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, me. Yes.
I want to talk to Mariko. Which one is she?
Mariko-san?
Mariko Nagoya.
Ah, so desu ka. Anokata desho.
Oh. Anokata desho.
Mariko-san does not work here. No more.
Doesn't work here anymore. Where's she work now?
Mariko-san gone away. Not say sayonara.
Huh?
Sayonara means goodbye.
したら私の主人がこんなに破ってしまいました。それから今日はみんな手ぬぐいを確かに調べておいてください。昨日はマリコ・ナゴヤ。なんておっしゃったのか分かりませんですけれど。それから20ほど新しいオケが来ますから、その繋ぎで。I'm looking for Mariko Nagoya Weber. I want to go in there and talk to her, understand? I just want to go in there and talk.
I want to go in and talk to her.
Look, Mariko Nagoya. Is she in there? Mariko Nagoya. That's right, Mariko Nagoya.
Oh, Nagoya Mariko.
Thank you.
like you.
I just want to know where to find your husband. I'm a friend of his. Eddie Spanier.
You are Eddie Spanier. When I heard you ask for him in a bathhouse, I was frightened. I had to run. I thought you were one of them.
Who'd you think I was?
One of the men who killed my husband.
Killed him?
He was shot down in the street. He died in the hospital the next day. I'm sorry to tell it to you like this.
Oh, that puts me in a great spot. I came all the way from the States.
He wrote to come over.
Said he had a deal cooking, was going to cut me in. Well, the news hit me below the belt, Mrs. Weber. Leaves me out on a limb. Who shot him?
I don't know. The newspaper said he died without talking.
What about the police? What'd they tell you?
They don't know about me.
Did you go to them?
No.
I don't get this. Your husband killed, you don't go to the police. It's the first thing anybody'd do. Why didn't you go to him?
He made me promise never to let anyone know we were married, no matter what happened to him.
Why? Was he ashamed?
No. He had his reasons. He never told me why.
Well, it was such a big secret. Why'd he write me about you?
I don't know. Maybe because he trusted you.
Well, how did it happen? Why was he shot?
I don't understand it. I still can't believe it. The man I married was gentle, kind. Oh, for 2 months, it was a paradise I always dreamed of. Then the newspaper said he was in a robbery and shot down by his own friend and left in the street.
Hey, take it easy. You'll be all right. Take it easy.
I didn't know what to do. I was afraid to go to the police. I didn't go back to the theater. I moved in with my uncle. There was no one to go to, no one to turn to. I was mixed up, shamed. I can't believe he was bad. I couldn't have married a thief.
Didn't know he was in that deep. He wrote me he managed a pachinko parlor in the Soxa district. There's nothing wrong with that. It's a legitimate business. I didn't figure he was in that deep. He must have got fouled up with the wrong crowd.
You think I should go to the police?
Nah, what good is it? You can't help them. Well?
I'm afraid.
Of what?
I'm afraid they will kill me the way they killed him.
It's smart of them to keep the marriage a secret. You had nothing to worry about as long as nobody knows you're his wife.
Who's the boss?
The fella in charge of the place.
The head man.
The number one boy.
Ah, so, so. Ichiban no shito. Ichiban no shito, Oku desu.
through the Ichiban?
Hi, konnichiwa.
You speak a little English?
Squishy, a little.
What's $25 in Japanese money?
So. ¥9,000 official rate. I give you 10% more.
So ¥9,000 is $25, huh?
Hi.
I come every week, collect ¥9,000 for protection. So nobody will do to you what I'm doing, okay?
Hi.
Who's the boss? You know the boss, the head man. You know the boss, the number one boy.
Ah, so, so. Ichiban, Ichiban. Red, red.
You mean the guy with the red coat?
Hi.
Hi, konnichiwa.
You speak a little English?
Of course, a little.
What's $25 in Japanese money?
Ah, so. ¥9,000 official rate. I give you 10% more.
I come every week, collect ¥9,000 for protection. So nobody will do to you what I'm doing, okay?
Wake him up.
Come on, answer the man. Answer the man!
Who are you working for?
Spaniard.
Who's he?
Me.
And who else?
Eddie.
Eddie who?
Spaniard.
I asked you who else you're working for.
I told you.
Well, Griff, you had it figured right.
Our Chicago mob was coming in to take over Tokyo. Well, that's what happens when you act like a hoodlum. Selling protection. You know, my pappy used to tell me about that while I was on his knee. Where you been the last 20 years, Eddie? What museum did you crawl out of?
What's it to you?
I don't remember seeing you around.
You will.
Well, you might give me that $50 you borrowed from my place.
Come on, give the man the money.
Charlie.
Yes, sir.
How many pachinko parlors are there in Tokyo?
Over 3,000, last count.
And more in Yokohama, Kobe, and Osaka. You go and sell them protection, Eddie. And stay out of Tokyo.
I beat it.
You
Ah, Pap, we should have seen that. The shake company. Today. Tokyo.
いらっしゃい。
Give me a cup of tea.
Kobu.
Huh?
Good to see you.
Oh.
How about the
octopus?
No.
Search me.
You have your passport?
Yeah, I got my passport.
Oi! Case on street, Trinity Kid!
Yes, we got a record on Eddie Spanier. Assault and armed robbery. Sentenced 3 to 5 years. Paroled after 2 years, 8 months.
Assault? Hey, I got it. Thanks, Corporal. So next time, I'll get this side.
The American Army has quite a record on you, Mr. Spanier.
That action's over.
Why did you come to Tokyo?
Is there a law against it?
No. But we don't like undesirable characters.
I served my time, my book's clean. Check with immigration on my passport.
They confirmed you had one when you docked. Sorry, why didn't I ridicule you? Do you have any friends in town?
No.
What did you do with the pearls?
Oh, I look like a pearl diver.
You were identified by the man as the thief.
Ready, E.K.
The charge against you has been dropped.
Am I supposed to decorate somebody?
He just telephoned his shop. The pearls are there. He had forgotten to take them. He's very sorry.
Very sorry, huh?
Yes, very sorry.
Hey, you.
Sandy told you to stay out of Tokyo.
He tell you to bring me in?
He asked me. In case I spotted you still in town.
Well, you spotted me. Let's go.
Take any chances. You better double check those figures yourself.
Yes, sir.
Make sure the flowers are ready for tonight.
Yes, sir.
That's all. Pachinko. pachinko parlors paid for this place. Used to belong to a baron. You're only off the boat a couple of days, and right away you get picked up by the cops.
How'd you know when I got off the boat?
Date stamped on your passport. You lost it. I got no use for it. You want to go to work for me?
I got my own plans.
Oh, sure. But that takes money. Organization takes friends. You got none of those three.
My mother didn't raise me to be a dog robber.
Well, you got Griff all wrong. He's my number one boy, my Ichiban. He was doing me a favor.
Now, they can do me one, drive me back, or he picked me up.
Well, it's your decision. Nobody's pushing you.
I'm not interested in working for any pachinko operator. Come on, Ichiban.
Who said anything about pachinko?
You didn't talk about anything else.
I've got other interests.
What kind?
Your kind.
What's in it for me?
Loot. Lots of it. Are you in or out?
I'm in.
Give the man a cigar. Come on. I'll show you around.
What a crummy-looking character.
What'd you say his name was again?
Spanier. Eddie Spanier. Man, he sure hit it off good with Sandy.
I don't like him.
Why not?
I don't like him. Your war record is one of the best I've ever seen. Assault and armed robbery. Sentenced 3 to 5 years. Paroled after 2 years, 8 months. Drafted 1943. Charged with homicide of second lieutenant. No witness, no conviction. Robbed division payroll, sentenced to military prison where he served the rest of the war. Dishonorably discharged. Arrested on mugging charge, no conviction. Assault and armed robbery, no conviction.
You working for the law? Where'd you get that rundown on me?
I got ways. Let's sit down, huh?
Plus getting me framed?
Well, I had to get you pinched so I could screen you. That's the way I built up my outfit. All ex-cons before they were drafted. All stockade hounds in the army, dishonorably discharged. Fine-looking ex-GIs to mix with the politest people in the politest nation in the world. And there's no hoodlum stuff. We don't even carry weapons. Here. Get yourself a suit with some style. Make yourself presentable. And report right back to me after you do.
私はデクが大好きなんですよ。そういえばアメリカにブルックリン・ドージャースという野球のチームがありますね。随分強いんでしょうね。日本からも今川上なんかが今野球の方へ行ってるんですけどね。私川上の大ファンなんですよ。アメリカへ週に一度でも行ってみたいと思ってるんですけどよ。向こうの野球はまた日本と違って面白いでしょ。
a pachinko operator named Sandy Dawson?
He's a petty racketeer who uses pachinko as a front, like many other criminals.
A front for what?
Other gambling interests. We know all about him.
Yeah? Well, he knows all about me is Eddie Spanier.
How could he know that?
He had my criminal and military record, the same one you had in your hand today.
Are you inferring somebody in my department?
I'm not inferring anything.
Maybe he got it from the Army.
Maybe. All I know is he had me picked up on that phony charge to get it.
You may have stumbled on something more than we expected. What other interest has he besides pachinko?
Don't know, except he runs his outfit like a five-star general and report right back.
Any link between him and Weber?
Don't know.
What about the stolen weapons and ammunition?
Carrying weapons is verboten. He hit that hard.
Stay with him. He might give you a lead.
What about the widow?
She's on the level. She knows nothing.
Think she suspected you?
Nah, that photo did the trick.
Forget her.
Looks like a wake.
Maybe it is. How long does it take you to buy a suit? Where have you been?
What do you want, a blow-by-blow account of everything I do?
Where'd you go?
On private business.
Your business is our business.
Not this kind. A strictly personal, a one-man operation.
Why waste time?
Where'd you go?
To see a kimono.
Who?
Now don't tell me girls are out of bounds.
Who's the girl?
You don't know her.
Who's the girl, Eddie?
Eddie Spaniard, do you know?
Eddie Spaniard.
Take it easy, Pop.
Give me some of the channel with the Lambo, you're
do you know any Americans?
No.
Where did you learn the language?
School.
You don't have an American boyfriend?
I don't know what you're talking about.
For the last couple of hours, was there another man here? A foreigner, a Westerner?
No.
We're wasting time.
Bring him in. Friend of yours?
No.
You never saw him before?
No.
How did you happen to pick her for such a phony alibi?
Was I here today?
Yes.
I told you my business was personal.
You came close to losing him permanently. Why did you lie? I don't understand you kimono girls. I don't know why you put a twist in a story and almost get a guy like Eddie in trouble. That isn't the way to act. Why did you lie? Ashamed? Because he's a foreigner, is that it? Don't you get it? Probably a relative, friend of the family. She'd lose face playing around with a foreigner. My apologies, Eddie, but we're entitled to one mistake. If you don't make a mistake, you never know when you're right. Sorry we wrapped you up, Uncle. Charlie, meet me at Pachinko number 4.
Yes, sir.
All right, Eddie, let's go. Give Grandpa a cigar.
Thank you.
you doing here? What do you want?
Eddie, I was afraid for you.
But you know where to find me.
I'm sorry, Eddie, but I did not know what to tell him. I was afraid to say I knew you. I was afraid to say I did not. Oh, I did not know what to say, Eddie.
Well, I had to hit you to make it look good. Did you follow me here?
My uncle did. He wants to go to the police.
You stopped him.
He's afraid
for me. Stop him.
Yes.
Tell him to keep out of this. The police learn about you, the killers learn it too.
That's why I stopped him. Are they the men who killed my husband?
Maybe.
Maybe they'll kill you?
Maybe they will. You better beat it.
I want to help you.
How can you help me?
I don't know, but...
There's no way you can help me. Unless maybe... forget it.
Oh, there is a way I can help. What can I do?
Are you sure you want to help?
Yes.
Stay here with me. All of Sandy's men have kimono girls. I can get one, too. It's easy. But I gotta have one I can trust, one that'll cover for me. Forget it. It's just an idea. Go on home to your uncle.
Good morning.
Good morning. Oh, it's wonderful coffee, just the way I like it.
Domo arigato.
Huh?
Oh, that means thank you.
It's not the same kimono you wore last night.
Oh, I've been out already, brought my clothes.
What does your uncle say about that?
He knows if I do this, there is a good reason for it. The bath is ready.
The bath?
Hi. Come. We take bath now.
We do?
I'll fix the breakfast. Oh, I bought fresh eggs this morning on the Ginza. Hot. In Japan, we like our baths boiling hot.
Well, you better go back to your eggs.
Yes. How do you like them?
You want a shingle?
Shingle. I know sunny side up and scrambled, but
do not know on a single.
Have you got any bread?
Oh, yes, I bought bread.
Yeah, well, all you do is you toast it and you put an egg on it.
You mean poached?
Yeah, poached. My eggs right now in the tub.
In the tub?
Yeah, I I always have my breakfast in the bathtub. Domo arigato.
You're welcome.
Your eggs will get cold. Just the way I like it.
Ohayo. 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 Ohayo.
Ohayo. Ohayo. Ohayo.
Ohayo. Ohayo. Ohayo. Ohayo. Ohayo. Ohayo. Ohayo. Ohayo. Ohayo.
Ohayo.
よしてちょうだい。うちの子にそんなもんいりません。ちょっとあっち行ってください。It's not you, Eddie. It's me. Me and my people. It's hard for you to understand. No foreigner does. But living with you here like this brings dishonor on them. And they hate any of us who give that impression to foreigners. I'm sorry, Eddie. I'm not strong enough to live this pretense. Inside it makes me sick. Cheap.
You better go.
You are not angry?
Nah, it was a bad idea from the start.
Sandy wants to see you. I'm in no hurry. Go ahead. Kiss her again.
Give me some light, Charlie. Our objective is the Kajaku Gravel and Cement Works on Hanshi Island in Tokyo Bay. We'll touch down at this dock here. You got it? You, Skipper.
Yes, sir.
You'll pull in this direction. While we attack, turn the boat around and be ready for an immediate withdrawal. You got that special equipment?
Yes, sir.
These are the latest photographs of the terrain.
This is the cashier's office.
Pull back immediately to exit A. And then to exit B. And then to the line of departure. Now I better fill you in on our casualties. A wounded man, whether in attack or withdrawal, is immediately killed by any one of us.
What?
Oh, I know it sounds inhuman, but so far it's paid off. That's why we're still operating. I handpicked every one of you, and you're only good as long as you don't stop a bullet. If you're hit, you're taken PW. And every man has a breaking point when questioned enough. Any man here will talk if his brains are washed right. Get that phone, Eddie.
Yeah?
What's the message?
The fog lifted. We're all set.
Well, let's go.
I haven't got a weapon.
You get one.
You're late.
I know. We're waiting for the fog to lift. We'll make it all right. This is Eddie Spanier. John has charge of the weapons.
Snub-nose 38. Griff. .45, Phil. .38, Charlie. .38, Willie.
How'd you do in the war? Knock off your ordnance sergeant?
I was the ordnance sergeant.
Hey, 9mm German job. That's a beautiful P-38, my specialty. I'll take one.
It's the only one in the outfit. Give him a weapon.
Thank you.
Somebody tell me why I saved Eddie? Countermanded my own order? You tell me. You're not my brother. I don't owe you anything. You never stuck out your neck for me. Why did I stop Griff from finishing you off? Maybe it's because it was your first job. Maybe that's it. But I'll tell you one thing. It'll never happen again. Bring her in. It's a flesh wound, nothing serious. Go on. You can use my house as a rest camp till you're able to get into action again. That room ready?
Yes, sir.
You're his kimono. You stay here, too. Take care of him. He'll show you where the room is.
This changes the whole setup.
Why, Eddie?
My old shack you could always cover for me. Now, that plan's impossible. I can't ask you to stay here, Mariko. This is dynamite, the two of us living right under his nose.
You're worried about me being in danger, aren't you?
Look, I got you into this. Figure story to tell Sandy, a reason why you left and didn't come back.
It will be dangerous for you, too.
Yeah, but I've got to stay here.
Why? Why?
It's my job to keep an eye on him. I'm getting paid for it.
What do you mean, getting paid? What are you talking about, Eddie?
I'm not Eddie Spanier.
Understand.
That photo was a fake. A real Eddie Spanier still in jail in America. I came to you hoping to find out something about your husband, about his connections.
Are you a policeman?
In a way.
Did my husband work for Sandy?
Yes.
Is it hard for you to put on this act with me?
It wasn't hard in the beginning.
They must pay you a great deal of money for the chances you have to take.
$190.30 a month. I'm a sergeant of the U.S. Army.
A soldier?
An army cop.
Eddie. Don't you have someone that will worry if you're in danger?
Everyone has somebody who worries about him. I have a dad. He's a carpenter in San Diego. That's where I come from, San Diego, California.
Anyone else?
My sister. She's 16, still in high school. My mother's dead.
Please let me help you. Please.
You're a wonderful girl, Mariko. I don't want anything to happen to you.
Thank you, Eddie.
Well, how's the casualty coming along?
I think I'll live, Charlie.
Hey, you're a pretty lucky guy. Set up like this? And a kimono like that to nurse you?
Did you bring me my purple heart?
No, but I brought you some good news. Sandy's throwing a shindig tonight in honor of that job we just pulled. He'd like to have you and the kimono be there.
Eddie and I will be there, Charlie.
Okay. Be seeing you.
Worried. I was thinking about Willie.
Forget him. Think I liked having him killed? He's gonna be tough to replace. But like I said, every wounded man has a breaking point when questioned by the police. We only leave corpses behind.
How do you know he was killed? You're moving fast, maybe.
I got ways of checking my casualties. Only once did we leave a wounded man behind, and he must have had a cast iron stomach. But he died in hospital the next day. He didn't talk.
Show him how to dance, huh?
You got your own kimono. Lay off mine.
You want to make something out of this?
If I was drunk, I'd throw you in that pool.
Why, you... Sit down, Griff. You know I don't like a beef when I throw a party.
Yeah.
And I don't like being shoved out of my number one position next to you. At a party or any place else. For the last couple of weeks, you've been worrying me, Griff, the way you act, the way you blow up. I don't like my itchy bond to worry me. It's bad for the outfit. Now wrap your arms around that kimono of yours and stay put.
Yes, sir. Don't let Griff get you down. Right from the start, he's had it in for me, and he took it out on you.
It isn't that. It's the way Sandy talked, how he killed my husband.
Say, why'd that girl poke the back of your neck with those chopsticks?
She was making fun of my neck.
Oh, is that what they were talking about?
Yes. In the old days, it was traditional for the refined Japanese woman to keep the back of her neck covered.
Yeah, why?
Well, in those days, it was the first thing a man found attractive in a woman.
Ooh, my aching back.
What's the matter, Eddie?
It's my neck this time. Ever since I stopped that bullet, I must be falling apart.
Come on, Eddie. I'll fix it for you.
Why did you land it? touch your fingers like that.
In Japan, a woman is taught from childhood to please a man.
That's the best custom yet. What's the first thing about a man?
The first thing?
You know. That's the first thing a Japanese woman finds attractive in a man. Broad shoulders?
No.
Muscles?
No.
There must be something that right away makes a Japanese woman want to...
There is.
What's the secret? Let me in on it. My what?
Your eyebrows.
My eyebrows?
Yes. You have the most romantic eyebrows I have ever seen.
I guess that's traditional, too.
Hi.
Hi. Means yes, huh?
Hi. You feel better now?
Yes, I feel much better now.
Well, good night.
Mariko.
Yes?
How do you say good night in Japanese?
Yasuminasai.
Now say, Mariko.
Yes.
Oyasuminasai.
This is the Bank of Tokyo. This is the alley.
This big gray armored bus. We got nothing like it in the States. It's a mobile bank on wheels. Packed with money to deliver to the banks of Tokyo. It's got bookkeepers, clerks, files, everything. It's a traveling mint. Now I'll be following in this red bus. Like this. The actual knockover will be at the intersection of 5th and Annex. Smitty, Benson, and Johnson will be dressed as Japanese laborers working the area with pick and shovel. Charlie and Phil will be in their cars with their groups here. Eddie will be here.
Wait a minute. At the last couple of briefings, everybody's been included in the act but me. Where do I come in?
You're sitting this one out.
What are you talking about?
You're not in this operation. You need a rest, Griff. You've been pitching too hard. You got battle fatigue. What happens to the best of us, it's nothing personal. But I've been watching you, and I'm worried. You're not responsible for what you're doing. I can't trust you in the line.
You can't trust me? What are you trying to do? Cut me out?
No, no. Nobody's going to cut you out. You'll get your full share of this operation.
Don't do me no favors, Sandy. I helped you organize this outfit. That's why I'm next in command. That was a deal. But ever since you saved this guy's neck, you've been acting funny. Oh, I know what you're trying to do. But you're not going to get away with it because I won't let you. You're not going to trade me in for some other Ichiban.
Take it easy.
Battle fatigue. That's a hot one.
Well, I could pull this job with just a couple of men. I don't need any two-bit...
You just knocked over the Bank of Tokyo, Griff.
All by yourself.
You see what I mean? Blowing your top? That's what I've been saying. You're not responsible for what you're doing. You've got no control. Absolutely no control. And I can't jeopardize this outfit. I don't know what you might do next. Wait a minute, Griff. You're just about ready for a Section 8. You better go home and get some rest. Come on.
Thank you.
Well, I'll finish the briefing.
Have you got it straight? His name is Captain Hansen. You're calling from a booth. You're telling me I have something for him from Sergeant Kenner. He'll tell you where to meet him. Now, this is what you give him. I've written out all the facts.
I'm frightened for you.
You better hurry.
Please be careful.
Captain Hansen.
I have something for you from Sergeant Kenner.
Who is this?
Mariko.
Where are you calling from?
Panudu Shop in Meguro.
Go to the Imperial Hotel. Room number 4. It's the second door on your left off the lounge. Have you got that clear?
Imperial Hotel, room 4.
Really a geisha girl?
Geisha. It's geisha. And anyway, I told you before.
That's
I never...
That's funny.
I see nothing funny about it.
Well, I wonder if she's got another boyfriend here.
What are you talking about?
Is Captain Hansen here?
I'm Captain Hansen. Where's the message from Sergeant Kenner?
Just time enough.
Thanks.
Sure hate to see that thing after an all-night bout with a jug of rice wine. That was a short romance. Holy smoke. Drink your drink. Drink your drink.
Cigarettes, please.
Hey. Come here. Come on. Come on. Here, I want to talk to you. Come on, sit down. Come on, come on. Relax, will you? Here. Right here, that's it. Right there. Let me put these down. Oh, you've been shopping for Eddie? That's nice. Now, look, what is your name? Don't tell me now. It's Mariko, isn't that it? Well, look, Mariko, I thought we ought to get to know each other better. You know, you're living in the house here, taking care of Eddie. I want you to feel welcome, like you belonged. Now, will you relax? Please. Now, are the servants treating you okay? You need anything? Well, if you do, you just let me know.
Because I want you to have the run of the house. After all, that's what it's for. How about some tea? Good for you. Everybody likes tea. Oh, come on, here. I never see Eddie with another girl. What's the matter? Do I make you nervous? He never seems to laugh anymore. What do you think's bothering him? Never seems to enjoy himself. You're what's bothering him. Charlie saw you coming out of that hotel room with a Westerner. Probably isn't the first time. Eddie can't trust you. That's what's bothering him. His number one girl is Ichiban, and you're two-timing him. Well, I don't care what you do, you cheap little tramp. But you're either going to stick to Eddie, or you're going to get out of here.
ただいま盗難について警戒警報がありました。
Men are ready.
The red bus should be 5 minutes from us.
Right down that alley, it'll take us to Fifth and Annex.
Are you sure he's got the P-38 on him?
He's got it.
Get off the Ginza! Turn down the first alley to the left.
Take off.
Move out.
Something went wrong.
What do you mean?
He's calling off the operation.
How do you know?
The music.
Drop me off at the arcade.
Why did you tip the cops, Griff? I can tell you why. Because you weren't responsible for your actions. Remember? I told you. You didn't know what you were doing. I could see you had no control of yourself. Absolutely none. And I knew, Griff. I knew. When you started blowing your buttons for no reason whatsoever. Griff, I wish I hadn't been right. But I was, Griff. Like always.
Maggie's waiting to see you, Mr. Dawson.
Who?
He would not tell me his name. He's out there.
What are you doing here? Any of the men see you?
I got here before they did.
Okay. What is it?
I know who informed the police.
I'm way ahead of you.
How'd you find out before I did?
I pay for information. I don't need you to think for me.
Be careful how you get rid of him.
I already have. Anything else?
No. Better lay low. The army'll never let up on you now that you've killed one of their own.
Wait a minute. What do you mean, one of their own?
Didn't you know he was an army investigator?
Are you out of your mind? A military police investigator, Griff? Well, I've known him since...
Griff, you've killed the wrong man. I am talking about Eddie Spanier.
Eddie?
Right after I left you in the red bus, I saw him with Inspector Keita and Captain Hansen of the MPCI. I saw him talking to them, standing right there on the street.
Are you sure it was Eddie?
I know Eddie Spanier. Didn't I get his record for you?
I screened him. Couldn't be an army cop. I screened him.
The army planted this record.
Beat it. enemy intelligence was on the ball. The police were wise.
The police? How could anybody tip them off? We're the only ones who knew.
That's right. We were the only ones who knew.
Got any ideas?
Sure. Sure, I know who tipped them off.
Who?
I never could figure a man who'd betray a friend. It must take some special kind of guy. A guy that gets a kick out of worming his way in and just when you get to like him. In goes the knife, right? Well, that's the way it goes. Takes all kinds. But I never figured Griff would go so far as to blow his lid to police headquarters.
Griff?
You mean Griff tipped him off?
Oh, yeah, it was Griff. Poor guy, he didn't know what he was doing. I'll say one thing. He sure knew how to die. Remember that Pearl job we had rigged for next month? The Osaka building?
Yeah.
Well, just so this day won't be a total loss, I'm going to put it into operation right away.
After what happened?
Sure. When the enemy thinks I got you on the run, counterattack. Don't wait to regroup. Hit him with a surprise maneuver. And this will surprise him, all right. For this, I'll need, Charlie. Oh, and Eddie. You too. Mr. Hamaro?
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, I'm out of cards. I met so many people today.
Ah, so?
My name is Phillips.
Mr. Phillips?
These are my associates, Mr. Henry.
Mr. Henry?
Mr. Brownlee.
Mr. Brownlee.
We'd like to look at some pearls.
Certainly. Any particular size?
The biggest and the best you've got.
Ah, so? Kochira dozo. Jōtō. Jōtō. Sa dozo. Oh, here. Finest quality. First grade. Ah. Please. See? Beautiful?
Ichiban.
Most beautiful in Tokyo. Most beautiful in Japan.
All right, Charlie. Eddie. Give him a hand. Get the pearls, Charlie. Cover him.
Huh?
Cover Eddie. Police headquarters? Get me somebody who can speak English. English! Yeah. All right, I'll wait. Sit down, Eddie.
Chotto, chotto. Oi, Kawada.
Hi.
Denwa, dareka eigo hanashitai da.
Hi. Can I help you?
Well, I, I want to tip you off about an armed robbery.
Armed robbery? Who is this calling? What is your name?
Never mind who I am. A friend of mine cut me out of a big deal, and he's got this coming to him. Now get this. Go to room 916, the Asakusa building.
It's a pearl shop.
Room 916.
Right. Oh, and watch your step. He's dangerous. He'll fire on sight.
Eddie, you're a man who appreciates my position. What would you do in my place? Suppose you were running my outfit and you picked up a spy. You know what the Army does when they find an enemy agent behind the lines. You think I'm going to kill you, don't you, Eddie? Well, I'm not. Not me. You know who's going to do it for me? The Japanese police. And they're going to find you loaded with pearls. That way, the Army can't blame me for killing one of their own. How do you like that for top-level strategy, huh?
Straightjacket, it fits you just right.
Can you think of a more brilliant maneuver? Well, I ought to be here in a few minutes. All right, Charlie.
Let's get out of here.
Now, wait a minute. Pick him up.
Why?
Pick him up.
I'll put him over here. We're over there?
Yeah.
Hold a minute. Hold a minute.
Cops will fire at the first man they see now. Is he all right?
Yeah.
Okay. He's up
there.
Let's go.
Hey! Wrap him up again!
Thank you. right, Sergeant. 一緒に行きなさい。
Take a look around.
Turning. A wheel, make it turn.